बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। दिस इज़ आवर सेकेंड लेक्चर एंड दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक मेथड्स टू स्टडी द मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर आई टोल्ड यू दैट देर आर द मैनी मैथड्स एंड द टेक्निक टू स्टडी द मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस ऑन द एक्सरे क्रिस्टलोग्राफी एंड for the study of the macromolecule and how to determine the structure of the macromolecule. Now we are going to study another technique, so we can say it's a part two of the topic methods to study the macromolecule. And this part two that lecture is we will focus on the topic spectroscopy and especially the mass spectroscopy. So the methods to study the macromolecule part 2 is the mass spectrometry. To recall what is the spectrometer and what is the spectrophotometer, we should know that any study or any interaction of the electromagnetic rays waves with the matter is called the spectrometry, and this interaction with the matter gives the characteristic feature of that matter or that molecule or the macromolecule, and give the characteristic feature of that matter, so we can get the characteristic knowledge about the specimen or about the sample under the spectrometry study. In this lecture, we will focus on the mass spectrometry, and we know that the mass spectrometry is the interaction of the light with the matter to determine its mass. Because it's clear from its name that mass spectroscopy is used to determine the mass of the micromolecule and the macromolecule. So, this will be another technique or the method to study the macromolecule. In this lecture, we will see the basic principle, how the mass spectrometry work and its instrumentation as well as its application. And it's one of the application is that we can determine correctly the mass of the macromolecule as well as the micromolecule and the samples from the different sources. So let's see the basic principle of the mass spectrometry. Actually, the mass spectrometry work on the principle that it produces the charged particle ions that are the positive ions, that are the cations from the macromolecules or any other chemical substance under study. And then it uses the magnetic or the electric field to direct those ions towards a detector, and at the detector it can be measured with the help of the mass to charge ratio. And in this way, a computer data system or database system be used to calculate the masses of all the ions produced by the macromolecule, and by addition of all that ions, the molecular structure or the mass of that macromolecules be determined. So to apply this principle, there should be a meter which can apply this technique accurately, and with the help of that meter the mass can be determined, and that meter is called mass spectrometer. A mass spectrometer is an instrument which can produce the charged particles are the ions from the chemical substance, and then with the help of the electrical magnetic field, that separated ion be directed towards a detector and measure their masses. So, if we schematically see that spectrophotometer, then there should be an inlet to input the sample, and there should be an ion source. An ion source will produce the ions or the cations of that introduced sample. A mass analyzer should be there, and an ion detector should be there, and the assembly of the ion source, mass analyzer and ion detector should be in a vacuum pump, because that ions should not be influenced by the gravity or by any other field. In this instrumentation, an important part is the ion generation. How to produce the ion of that macromolecule? To produce the ion of that macromolecule, we need to have the accelerated electrons that can be produced from the tungsten or the copper filament. By producing the 70 volt potential, and if we heat them, the filament of the tungsten or the copper, the electron will be produced and will travel towards the anode. Electrons are the negatively charged particles, so if there is a powerful anode, they will fastly move towards the anode side. And if there is an inlet and a sample of macromolecule is present in their way, they will be automatically bombarded on that sample. And when the fast moving electron will be bombarded on that one, they will remove the electron from the outermost shells of the molecule or the macromolecules. So by removing the electron, they will make them the positively charged particles that may be of different fragment length. Molecules travel towards the cathode, and from that cathode they will be directed towards the analyzer, and with the help of the magnetic field they can be directed in a circular path, and that circular path hit towards the detector, and the ions, the cations or the positively charged ions of the macromolecules, when will pass through the detector will detect their strength and will calculate them. And in this way, the total masses of the ions produced by a macromolecule be determined. In this, spectral lines are obtained, which are called the spectrogram of that macromolecule. How the spectral lines are obtained and how a molecule or the macromolecule under study give the spectral lines, for that we have to see some examples. And if we see the some examples, then we come to know how the mass spectrometer is used to determine the molecular mass of a macromolecule. This spectral information, actually the peaks which are produced by the frequency and the masses of that macromolecule which is under studies, and the ions which are produced by them. So let us take an example of water, because water is a simple molecule, and to take it as an example, it will be useful for our understanding. So So if a beam of electron is directed through the water vapors in the source of a mass spectrometer, some of the electron will hit the water molecules, okay, and then knock off an electron, producing the charge ions from the water. So if we will see this one in an equation form, water plus one force electron gives the H2O positive ions plus two electron in the resultant equation. And we know that all of the collision will not be of the same strength. Some of the collision between the water molecule and the electron will be so hard that the water molecule will be broken down into different fragments. So if we consider the fragmentation of the water, we can see that there can be the OH positive ion, oxygen positive ion, and hydrogen positive ion with the different masses. And if we calculate the mass of that ions, then H plus will equal to 1, O plus equal to 16, hydroxyl plus OH plus ion will be equal to 17, and water H2O plus ions will be equal to 18 AMU mass unit. And the data system, or the spectrum which will be obtained from the data system of the instrumentation, will make a graph, will give the peaks of relative abundance to the mass to charge ratio of that ions. And if there are the very small number of H plus ions and it has the lowest mass, so first of all in the spectrum the H plus ion peak will be appear, and normally there are very very small number of H plus ion, so the relative abundance of that peak is very small. After that the oxygen molecular weight is, after the hydrogen molecular weight, mass, and mass to charge ratio of hydrogen and oxygen is equal because both have the one charge on it. So if their mass divided by their charge, their mass to charge ratio will be equal to their masses. After that, oxygen plus ion have the very low relative abundance, so they will be the peak of oxygen plus with the 16 mass. And then OH positive ions are relatively greater than the hydrogen positive ion and the oxygen positive ion, and its relative abundance is more than the remaining two ions, so the OH positive ions peak will be clearly visible. But the most abundant, the highest percentage of the ion peak is H2O positive ion peak, because the water molecule is the polar solvent and the bombardment of atom could not break them as much as they can break the non-organic solvent. So the bombarded atom only removed the one electron from the whole water molecule, and the water molecule become a water ion, H2O positive ion, and that ion is the highest relative abundance towards the other ion, so it has the highest peak in the mass spectrum of water. There is another example of alkanes, and the representative member of the alkane is the hexane, 6 carbon atom, saturated hydrocarbon. The molecular ion peaks which are present in the spectrum of the hexane, it has the different fragmentation and with the difference of the 14 mass unit apart. CH3 positive, CH3 bond, CH2 positive peak, CH3 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 peak, and then CH3 bond, CH3 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 positive peak, and then CH3, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 positive peak. So in this spectrum, there are 5 to 6 peak with the relative abundance of high frequency, and the highest relative intensity peak is the CH3 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 peak. So the fragmentation which made by the spectrophotometer and the ions which are formed, positive ions which are formed by the spectrophotometer in the case of the hexane are the 5, and with the highest one is CH3 bound CH2 bound CH2 bound CH2. So we can say that the highest fragment of the hexane, if we remove the CH3 CH2 group from the hexane, then the remaining part have the highest peak. If we take the example of the aromatics, that are the cyclic rings, close cyclic rings, the naphthalene is the best example of that one. In the case of the aromatics, there is only one peak, which shows that the naphthalene has the delocalized electrons. Delocalization make them a stable structure, and if we hit with the electron, bombardment of the electron, the molecule of the naphthalene, then its delocalized electron change their position, and there is very hardly a removal of one electron from the molecule. It cannot break the naphthalene into the fragment, and only the one ion be possible that is equal to the molecular weight of that molecule. So in this way we can have the spectral lines of all the molecules and the macromolecules in the database, and if we want to determine or to check the molecular mass of any complex, any simple molecules, we can use the mass spectrometer to determine its molecular weight, its mass, and compared with the database already present in the mass spectrophotometry database, we can know what is the molecular mass of this new macromolecule or the new micromolecule or the complex of chemicals. And this is a very basic information to know about the molecules and the ions. So this is another technique to study the macromolecule. I have discussed here the 4 examples of the molecules and how to determine its mass from the mass spectrometry. There are the 2 or 3 more examples present in the video, and I'm not going to discuss that one. In summary, we can say that each molecule has a characteristic fragmentation pattern which can be used to identify the molecule
and its molecular weight. Thank you.